All right, welcome to Reading High School. This is the Reading Pop Warner C team taking on the Burlington Raiders.
Is it the Raiders?
It's the Raiders.
Oh.
So this is going to be an exciting game. We got a few captains out there, but there's one official captain. It is Ben Wright, number 3. Who else do we have out there? Colin Donahue, number 71. 54, Matt DeCourcy, 42. Rowan Manahan, 40. Dylan Sweetser, and 41, Jason Anderson. The only player that hasn't been a captain yet this year is Ben Wright and Michael Fabiano, who's going to be showing up later for the game. He's delayed, but he'll be a captain this game, too. So the toss has been made, and we have, looks like Reading's going to kick off. Tom, great win last week for Reading against Methuen. They came back after that tough loss from Westford.
Yeah, very enjoyable game. Very enjoyable game.
A lot of big plays, a lot of long plays.
A lot of anger during that game on the Burlington side.
The Methuen, yeah.
Methuen side.
Yeah, well, they had a lot of guys go down and tough injuries, and I think there was some frustration.
Yeah.
It didn't look like there was any dirty play by the Reading team, but maybe they perceived some.
No.
But good win. Nice bounce back after a tough loss for Westford, so it was exciting.
It was. It was an exciting game.
We've heard a little bit about this team from Burlington. They're a strong running team. And
although their record doesn't show it, they said.
Yeah, they got a losing record, but they did beat Trakett, who we beat a couple weeks ago by about the same margin. So
okay.
That's just a measuring stick. We
Fantastic.
Got McCarthy. McCarthy's joined
Dolan
us.
Just joined us up here in the booth while Tom's we're live.
Son. This
right
is
now,
exciting.
So he can step
we
away.
We also have some Burlington fans that joined us in the booth as well. Some, that's great.
I'm going to.
Okay, we'll get ready for kickoff.
Here we go for the kickoff.
Giacomo Iapica back for the kickoff. And here we go. It's an onside kick. It's a double onside kick. I think that's an illegal touch, but they don't drop a flag on it. So it looks like they missed that, and it's going to be Burlington ball at the – oh, no, they did see it. They're going to mark it where the second touch was. And Burlington will take over at Reading's 45-yard line. Oh, okay. First and 10 for Burlington on Reading's 45-yard line. It's a tight formation. Looks like a run formation. 27 goes in motion. It's a pitch. Illegal motion. They're going to move him back 5. It'll be first and 15 to go. Second and 15 for Burlington. Looks like the same play, and it is a quick pitch. And again, the referees don't like the motion in the backfield.
Certainly not.
So they're going to move him back. It'll be first and 20. Second and 20. I mean, first down and 20. And it's another pitch and maybe a gain of a couple. And it'll be second and long for Burlington. Second and 19 for Burlington. A lot of plays and still second down. As quick pitch, and they do not like this offensive set. I think the coach for Burlington needs to talk to the referees. This play is not working. They're going to be second and 25. He must be seeing that guy go in motion. Okay. So second and 25 after 15 yards of penalties. More strange motion. Pitch right. Looks like Reading has contained, and they're going to swarm him, and it'll be third and long for Burlington. Third and 25. Doesn't look like they're punting here, Tom. They're going to go for
typically it. Typically don't punt on third down, though, Dave.
Oh, it's third down. And another penalty. Oh, my God. I can't believe this.
That was of the likes of Frank Rizza on that comment.
Tom, you can see why I would think it would be fourth down. They've got no yardage, and they've made 8 plays already.
No doubt.
Jeez, I got a good excuse. And now, finally, the Burlington coach
That's
is going to talk.
That's the end of the first quarter.
You got me.
We're going.
Is it still third down, Tom?
I believe it is.
Still third down.
Start of the second quarter.
We've had 10 plays and no yardage gains. And it's still third down. And again, no yardage. So now it is fourth down, Tom Dolan.
And I believe they're going to go for it on this one.
They are. I think there's a high likelihood they'll get it. What a crazy start to a ball game. Fourth and forever for the Raiders. It's a pitch to the other side for once, and they might get a yard. So they had about 10 plays, a gain of maybe 2 yards total, and a loss of 25 yards on penalties.
Yeah.
That's quite a first series.
That is.
We'll take over the ball on downs.
I can't figure out why Burlington's hasn't won a game yet this season.
They did. They beat Drake.
Oh, did they?
Yeah,
that's right. They did.
Same
team
we beat.
Oh,
and they beat them by about the same amount we did.
Perfect. Well, here we go. We're continuing live.
So we take over on downs, and we're on the 36-yard line of Burlington. James Murphy behind center. Kobe Goodchild in the backfield, along with Aiden Beckenhuis as the fullback. It's a handoff to, oh, no, it's a roll right. It's a fake handoff. Murphy has an open receiver, and that looks like Jesse Daugherty.
Flag on the
no,
play.
No, it's not. Yeah, it is Jesse Daugherty. Maybe blocking downfield, and it is. Yep. That play took a long time to develop, and some of the offensive linemen might have slipped down in the blocking a little bit. So we've had about 8 penalties here so far. They'll redo first down. First and 15 for Reading. Shotgun to Murphy. He's got Strout to the right on a screen pass. He turns it upfield. He's going to have the first down. Oh, almost the first down. Second and short. Second and 3 for Reading after a nice throw and catch with Murphy and Strout. And this is to Iapika, incomplete. Third and 3 for Reading after that incompletion. Oh, got a little motion, but they didn't call that. Oh, ball on the ground. And it was recovered by Reading, and I don't think they're going to punt. They'll go for this.
Given the way they've been hitting those extra points, Dave, in the practice,
maybe they'll go for a field goal. They did hit their first extra point kick last week. That was great.
Here we go.
Fourth down. Beckenhuis in motion. It's a pitch to Goodchild. Goodchild has the first down and more. He breaks a couple tackles. He's turning up to the 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Colby Goodchild.
What a run. Fantastic.
He's been doing this all year. Great run. So we got a 6-0 lead with 5 minutes left in the first quarter. Let's see if they go for two again, Tom, with the kick.
It'll be interesting.
Look at the cheerleaders doing push-ups over here, Tom. Can you get that on video?
I might be able to. Rich might be in our way.
Trying to motivate the team.
Look at that.
Very impressive. The physical fitness of these cheerleaders. All right, it's set up for the extra point. And it looks like they're going to go for one. We got Beckenhuis and Goodchild. Beckenhuis, our power running back. And Goodchild, the elusive back. And it's to Goodchild. No, it was Rocco Masciarelli. I called that wrong. As my son pointed out to me when they watched the games as a team that I sometimes call the wrong players.
It doesn't matter.
Feedback's a gift, huh? It
doesn't matter, though, Dave. That voice goes a long way.
We're live. Okay. Yeah, but here we go. Kickoff. 6-0 for Reading after a great drive. And we got an onside kick. It looks like they have a chance. But Burlington covers it up. Okay, first down and 10 for Burlington, who I called the wrong name. They're actually the Burlington Patriots as a C team. I was calling them by their high school name.
Saw that on the back of a car. My son didn't want to wear his Patriots hat into the game today because he felt he'd be rooting for the wrong team.
Tom, thanks for correcting me, though. I would have been doing that wrong the whole game.
That's okay.
That was Burlington's best pickup so far, a 2-yard gain. And it's going to be second down at about 8. And maybe no gain. They're swarming on defense today. Who's in on the tackle there? Zach Galvin was in on the tackle. And also Max Rizzo. Third and eight for Burlington. They got pulling guards on that one, and it's going to be a fourth down and about seven. Poeli in on that last stop. Got a lot of substitutions on defense. Fourth down for the Patriots. Ball's on the ground, and DiNapoli recovers it. Fumble recovery for the Reading Rockets. They'll take over on Burlington's 45-yard line. First and 10 for Reading at Burlington's 45-yard line. Ben Wright checks in it as the back, captain of the team. We'll be doing a player profile for him in a few minutes. He's got a sweep going out, and they stop him for a loss. Kind of an arm tackle by the Burlington player. Second and long for Reading. Second and 17. Rocco Marciarelli's checked in at quarterback with Ben Wright as the back. Shotgun. He's got the ball. He's got pursuit. Hits the open man. Quinn Dolan. Incomplete.
Five.
Third and 16 for Reading. Marciarelli under center. He looks to pass, then hands it off to Ben Wright. He's got some running room. He breaks a tackle. He's down to the 30, 20, 10. He's going all the way for a touchdown for Ben Wright. It's 12-0 for Reading. While we're focusing in on Ben Wright, why don't we just go right with his player profile? Good time to do it,
fantastic,
right? After he
time.
Scores a touchdown, great run. He's a Coolidge middle schooler, sixth grade, number three, as you know. When he's not rooting for the New England Patriots, he roots for the Dolphins. His favorite candy is a Hershey bar. Favorite historical football player is Joe Montana. Loves to do the offensive drills in practice. We got a timeout in the field. His favorite movie is The Benchwarmers. Loves playing baseball when he's not playing football. And his favorite place to go with his family in Reading is Capri Pizza. And this first quarter is brought to you by Capri Pizza, a fine establishment.
Didn't know we were doing advertising these days.
Oh, yeah, we throw free advertising to some of our favorite places.
Free pizzas
like Dandelions and Capri. Well, we got a lot of – this video will go viral. We'll get a lot of hits on
That's
it.
That's right.
So it's good. Ben Wright is really our running back that gets to the corner and uses his foot speed to get around the edge. He does a nice job of that. So, all right, we're going to go for the extra point here, and it looks like we're setting up, and it's
going
to be
Giacomo.
Giacomo's going to go for the two-point conversion, try to go up 14-0. Again, we made our first one last week. I think that was Thomas Frater that made that kick last week. Is that right?
No, it was Sweeney.
Sweetzer.
Sweetzer, yes.
Dylan Sweetzer.
Yes.
Rocco sets it, and here's the kick. It's blocked. So it'll be 12-0 with 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Set for kickoff. Giacomo's lining up his kick. He gets the right set. He gets the left set. And here's the kickoff. Another onside kick. Ball's loose. Ball's loose. Who's going to get it? It looks like Burlington recovered it. Chippy block by Burlington. First down for Burlington on their own 38-yard line. A pitch to left. Got a little bit. Nope. Maybe a yard.
Stacked him up nicely on that.
Second
hit.
And nine. Well, things have gone perfect so far. Was it Colby Goodchild?
Yeah.
Things have gone
Go
perfect
figure.
For Reading so far.
Kids all over the field.
He really is. Okay, we got DiNapoli on the end. I see Poeli in there. Murphy, Marciarelli. Who's on the other end? Sometimes hard to see the lineman numbers from this angle, Tom. Second down and nine. Looks like misdirection, but Reading is not fooled. Good contain on that. And on the tackle,
Everybody.
Everybody. Joe Puelli seems to be the one that made the wrap-up there. A lot of substitutions so far. This is good to see a lot of players get in the game. And we're a little shorthanded, so it's kind of the next man up. Colin Donahue got hurt, not a football-related injury. He hopes to be back next week. We have a couple other players that are
He'll certainly
not here.
Be missed this week.
Yep.
Yeah.
Strong line play both ways by Colin. Third and eight. 27 in motion for Burlington. It's one of those Edelman sweeps, and Redding is all over it. See Rocco cleaning up on it. Was that Ryan Strout that also was the first one to be to the ball? No, that was Jesse Daugherty. Jesse Daugherty the first one there, and then him and Rocco brought him down. Fourth down and 16 for Burlington. We haven't seen them throw the ball yet, Tom. I don't think,
no,
have we?
No, which we could be in for one of those right now. Yeah.
Doesn't look like a throwing formation.
Nope.
It is, though. He's going to throw it. He has an open man, but it's incomplete. So we'll take over on downs at Burlington's 34-yard line. Start of the second quarter. Redding taking over the ball at Burlington's 34-yard line. Murphy in the shotgun. He's looking left. He looks like he's going to – it's a keeper. It was a designed keeper. He's going to have 5, 10, maybe 15 yards on that. Or is it 10 yards? Let's see where they mark it here. It's coming. So a 9-yard pickup on the quarterback keeper. Murphy goes under center. He's got Strout to his left. Colby Goodchild to his right. Marsharelli in the backfield. It's a handoff to Marsharelli. He's got some running room. He's going to take it to the 15, 10, 5. He's going for the goal line. Do they get him? Flag on the play. That might be coming back. Sorry if I cut off your camera angle, Tom.
We're having a tough one on the corner anyways over there in that corner of the end zone. Maybe not sure we can move it.
Want to move it where Rich is? So we had a penalty on the play. I think it was a defensive penalty because we have a first down. Must have been a holding. So Murphy rolling right. He has an open receiver. And that's Jesse Daugherty. I think another 10 yards, another first down. It's another Redding first down. Move the chains. And they're in the hurry-up offense. They're on a mission in this game. They're just trying to drive it down their throats here. Murphy in the shotgun. Oh, it's over his head. He's going to pounce. Oh, no, he's going to throw it away. Is that DiNapoli? Maybe for a loss of three.
Quick thinking on Murphy's part. On
yeah,
that one.
He scooped it up.
Scooped it up, made a play, dropped it off for a couple more.
Got a couple yards back anyway. A
couple yards back, exactly.
Second and long for Redding. Hand off to Marsharelli. He's got about a pickup of five. He's moving the pile, though. Maybe 7 yards. Got some of that loss back. And now it's going to be third and about 8 yards to go. Third and nine.
Oh.
Third and long for Redding. Murphy's looking to throw. It's knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Fourth and long for Redding. All right. Fourth and long for Redding. Fourth and 10. Murphy's rolling left. He's got an open receiver. It's Jesse Daugherty. I think he's going to score. He does. Our Gronk scores another touchdown. It's 18-0.
No.
That was a great play. Colin Sweetser, who made an extra point kick last week up in Methuen, is set to kick again. Let's see if they can have some tight blocking here to give it a good chance to go for two. It's down. The kick is up. And it is short. It's a live play, though. They can run this back for 2 points. No, they can't. Play's over. So it's 18-0. And we're second quarter now, but I think. Okay, kickoff. Are we live?
We're live.
Giacomo Iapica set to kick off. Oh, we get the ball rolling off the tee. We're probably going to have somebody go in there and have to hold that. Max Leone's going to hold it for him here. Getting a lot of instruction from the special teams coach, Bill Robichaud. Set for kickoff. They go with the deep kickoff this time. Fielded cleanly by Burlington. Patriots. And they run it back for about 8 yards, and they'll take over at their own 45-yard line. Okay. First down for the Patriots. It's a handoff up the middle. Beckenhuisen on the tackle.
Ooh, is the ball on the ground?
Nope, looked like the ball on the ground. Rocco, yeah. Marciarelli, Beckenhuisen. Second down and 10. We got Stroud in there. We got Hennessy, Beckenhuisen. Eamon Centrella on the left defensive end.
Timeout on the play.
Also, Sean Murphy's in on there, in there, and Tim Burns on the line of scrimmage, nose guard. Live with our fans profile. We got the whole Reading contingent over here. Who do you see in the crowd? I see the Toppiers.
Yep.
I see
Amy Dolan.
Pina Rizza sitting next to her.
Rizza.
There's the Panos family. Ben's uncle and nephew and cousins, Amy Hennessy. We see Vicky. Vicky, the Ramos grandmother. Who else? We have Julie Ramo. We see Jane Burns and Tim Burns.
Going back live to the game.
The fire chief over there, Tim Burns, is dead. All right. It's second down and long. And who's in on the tackle? Oh, we got a host of tacklers in here for Reading. I see Dylan Sweetser in on the tackle. Max Leone down there. 72, who's that? Sean Murphy was in on that. Ben Wright checking in the game. Marciarelli coming out. Third down and 10. It's a reverse. Ben Wright's chasing him down. And he chases him down out of bounds, and he's short of the first down. Ben Wright using his speed on that one to track down that play. Fourth and 3. It's a pitch to left side. Turns it up to the middle. They're going to get their first down. First down for Burlington.
Reading's in trouble now.
18 to nothing. And now Burlington's making their move. Stroke coming off.
It's not how you start, Dave. It's how you finish.
That's right. Sean Murphy in on the line. Josh Robichaud is the left defensive end. Alex DiNapoli is the right defensive end. First down and 10. It's a reverse. Ball's on the ground.
Oh.
Ball's on the ground. Who's going to recover it? Reading recovers. Fumble recovery for Reading. They're going to take over. And who comes up with the ball here? I think that was Max Leone. Is that the one? Or it was either Max Leone or Tim Burns. I think it might have combined on that.
Sorry, coaches, for that. The camera was off the play when that ball went
Eamon
to the ground.
Eamon Centrella as well. Looks like they're giving a lot of congratulations to Eamon Centrella as well. He might have recovered. So it was a team tackle there. Am I talking live right now?
You're live.
Oh, yeah, this is exciting. First and 10. Rocco's back in at quarterback. We have Max Leone spit out left. He's got an open receiver. Just out of the outstretched hands of Jack Ramo. Harappy offense, second and 10 for Reading. Leone out left. Looks like Ramo out right. Ben Wright, the split.
Dolan
right. It's Dolan out right. Yeah. It's a handoff up the middle. Beckenhuisen, he has running room. He's tackled from behind after almost a first down. We'll see where they spot it here. It's going to be close. Looks like they're just short by about a half a yard or a yard. We expect to see some power running right now. I wouldn't be surprised if Aiden Beckenhue's got this ball if he's in the game.
He'll probably start keeping it on the ground, I think.
Third and short. We have Ben Wright, the deep back. Dolan out right. Leone left. Hand off to Ben Wright up the middle. He's swarm tackle. They anticipated that. Now they're going to have fourth and a couple, maybe three, to get the first down. Five minutes left to go in this first half. Rocco Marcirelli in the center. About 3 yards to go for first down. It's a pitch to Ben Wright. He's going to move it out to the right side. He has the speed to get to the corner. Let's see if he can turn it. Almost. Just one more tackler to beat. He would have got the first down and more. So they'll turn it over on downs. I think that's the first unsuccessful offensive series for Reading so far. And Burlington will take over on their own 43-yard line. First and 10. First and 10 for Burlington. It's a handoff out the middle. They're going to get about 5 or 6 yards, 7 yards. Almost a first down. Burlington's starting to find their stride a little bit on offense. They're starting to move the ball a little bit.
They are.
First and 10. Nice pickup of 10 yards for Burlington on that one. Handoff up the middle. Some power running. Good hit in the middle. Eamon Centrella is bringing him down. Max Rizzer in on the tackle as well. We have a Burlington player down right now. Second and 6 for Burlington. Their player got off the field under his own power. Hopefully he's okay. Oh, we got the player running off the field to get off in time. Looks like Redding's going to call a timeout. Too many men on the field, so we call the timeout to avoid that 5-yard penalty. Second and 6 for the Burlington Patriots. It's a pitch to the right. And are they going to hold them? Oh, they're moving the pile. And I think Burlington might have got the first down there. Or just short of it. Just short of it. Just short of a first down. It's going to be third and less than a yard. Fine. Well, we had some excitement in the press box here as Tom Dolan's coffee got caught by a gust of wind.
Yeah, it was somebody threw something at me.
And his coffee went flying into the stands. We hope nobody got wet. Was it caught still, Tom?
No, it was iced coffee.
All right. At least nobody got hurt.
Worse on a cold day.
At least nobody got hurt. There's always something that is exciting happens in this booth here. So fourth and short. And Burlington does pick up the first down. So they're starting to get a little bit of momentum on offense to the Burlington Patriots. They've been moving the chains a little bit now. So maybe wearing us down. We did hear they have a pretty good power running game. Burlington cannot take them lightly. This is still the first half. They're only down by 3 scores. It's a pitch to the right. And he's breaking it. Ryan Strout wraps him up. He was not going to let him score on that. Nice tackle by Ryan. Rocco helped out as well. First down for Reading with a minute left to go in this first half. That's what the stadium clock says. We don't know what the official time
is. First down for Burlington. Right?
Did I say? Oh, I said Reading.
You said Reading.
Yeah. Timeout for Burlington, for the Burlington Patriots. First and 10 for Burlington on Reading's 15-yard line. This is easily their best drive of the game with a 1:27 left, we just found out. Official clock. He's got an open receiver. It's a touchdown. They connected deep. 18-6. We get a ball game. Burlington, for a team that doesn't throw well, that was quite a throw and catch. Nice route. Unexpected by the Reading defense. It's a pitch to the right. They're going to go for one here in the conversion, and they have it. So it's 18-7. What looked like it was going to be a complete blowout is now a game that's a little bit more in doubt.
I don't think there's any doubt, Steve.
I can be the retired ref and replay stuff.
And here we go, kickoff.
Here we go for kickoff. And we hear shouts from the crowd. Watch the onside kick. Let's see what we have here. It's not an onside kick. They kick it mid-level. And it's fielded cleanly by Alex DiNapoli. Takes it for a couple yards. The most important thing, fielding that cleanly. Nice play by him. Yeah. First down and 10 from Redding's own 45-yard line. First and 10 for Redding. Marciarelli under center. Oh, nope. It wasn't Marciarelli. It was Murphy, and he just nailed it down. We'll go to halftime. Good first half. We got a ball game. At least, Tom, you know, it seemed like it was all one way there, but now we have a more interesting second half with Burlington coming back and scoring, getting seven. We're going to do a player profile right now if he's here.
I still haven't seen him.
Nope. Player profile just before the second half here of a 18-7 game. It's Michael Fabiano, number 73. He's a Parker middle schooler, sixth grade. His self-proclaimed nickname is Fabs.
I was going to guess that.
His favorite musical artist is Guns N' Roses. That's from our generation, Tom.
Yeah.
He roots
Sweet
for the Arizona.
Child of mine.
Yeah, that's right.
That.
He roots for the Arizona Cardinals when he's rooting for the Patriots. Loves Twix bars. Coming up for Halloween, I'm sure he'll get some of those. Enjoyed watching Bo Jackson highlights, probably on recordings. I'm sure he saw none of his games live at his age. His favorite movie is The Scream, another good Halloween-type reference. Likes to play hockey when he's not playing football. And like a lot of the kids, his favorite place to go in Reading with his family is Dandelions.
Looks like we have a
in the second
lined
half,
up on the wrong side of the field here.
Oh, yeah, switch him around. That's good. Have more time to talk about Michael Fabiano.
Mr. Fabiano.
And this Fast. Second half is brought to you by Dandelions, our sponsor. Second half about to start. Reading will receive the kickoff as they deferred. They've learned that from Bill Belichick. And here's our kickoff. It's a deep kickoff. Kobe Goodchild's going to scoop it up. He's going to turn it upfield. He's got a little running room to the left. Oh, I think he could make something here. He turns it. He cuts it up. He's going to go up to the 40, 30, 20. 10, he's gone. Kobe Goodchild runs back the kickoff. What a start to the second half. He is a great runner. You can almost see the lane. You could see him see that he had the lane and just took it. And he had the speed. So it's 24-7. For 2-1 on this, McCarthy. We have McCarthy Dolan, Quinn Dolan's brother, in the booth with us. He's on the headset. It's a pass.
Oh.
Incomplete. What'd you think of that, McCarthy?
Not good.
That wasn't good.
Pass interference?
No.
Now, McCarthy, that's an interesting name. How did you get the name McCarthy? Is that a family name, or is it just, you know, how your parents named you, McCarthy? No?
No.
All right. What's your favorite sport? What do you like to play?
Lacrosse.
Lacrosse.
Baseball. Lacrosse and baseball.
Lacrosse and baseball. Lacrosse is a good sport for learning how to play football. Oh, and do you also play flag football, too? Is that true? Yeah. Who's your coach for flag football?
My dad.
Your dad? Wow. What's your record?
We're undefeated.
Undefeated? And what position do you play in flag football, McCarthy?
Like, everyone plays everything.
Everyone plays everything. Have you scored any touchdowns?
Yeah.
Awesome. And you, yeah, the coaching's a little weak, I heard, on your team, though, huh? It's. He's just giggling. Well, Quinn almost had a nice completion out there, your brother.
Yeah.
You like watching him play football?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to have the kickoff here. We have Giacomo Iapica kicking off. And McCarthy Dolan, our first profile of a sibling of one of the players. This is exciting. Thank you. Thank you, McCarthy. He's heading back to the stands, sprinting. Okay, first down and 10 for Burlington. Some strange motion there, but it works for them. They get a couple yards. It'll be second and 7 for Burlington. Second and 7 for Burlington. It's a handoff, reverse handoff. And he's brought down after a couple. Rowan Manahan was in on the tackle. Seemed to trip him up as he was coming around. Jesse Jarvie checks into the game for Aiden Beckenhuis at left defensive end. We have Jason Anderson on the nose tackle. It's a handoff. Reverse again. This time they have the corner. They're going to get 10, 20 yards here, down to the 40. And we have Ryan Strout again coming back and making a big tackle.
Huge tackle.
So he's coming from that right defensive end, and he's not giving up on the plays. He's done that twice now, to come from the right defensive end to make a tackle down the left sideline.
That kid's got some wheels on him. He can run just about anybody down.
And the desire to make sure that play doesn't turn into a touchdown. That's good pursuit. Yeah, good angle of pursuit.
Great camera work.
Okay, first down and 10 for Burlington. Good camera work on that play. A little shaky by Tom. Oh, I think, does Redding recover the ball? Yes. Redding recovers the ball. Who comes up with it there? I think that was Alec Grande with the big recovery on the fumble. First and 10 for Redding from their own 29-yard line. Murphy has a reverse coming over his own here. And that's to Alex DiNapoli. Big pickup. That was wide open. Good 20-yard pickup for Redding on the reverse sweep.
Fantastic play calling.
First and 10 for Redding after that great play from their own 49-yard line. Murphy under center. DiNapoli split out left. It's a handoff to Ben Wright. He's got some running room. Breaks a couple tackles. Almost gets another first down. Second and 1 for Redding. All right. Second and 2 for Redding. Shotgun for Murphy. Ben Wright is only back. Puelli to the left. He's looking at Puelli. He has him. Big block by Jesse Jarvie. Puelli breaks a tackle and gets another first down. Maybe probably about 10 yards in that pickup. Big play. Nice screen play. First and 10 for Redding. After a great catch and throw, Murphy to Puelli for first down and about a 10, 12-yard pickup. On their own 30. It's a pitch to Rocco Marciarella. He swarmed. I think they had Beckenhuis coming back around, but he could not pitch. He was smart just to take that down. Second and 15 for Redding after that loss. Beckenhuis in motion. We got some motion on the line of scrimmage. They're going to bring that back. It's going to be second and 20. Iapika split out left. Beckenhuis in the slot. DiNapoli out right. It's a handoff up the middle to Marciarella. He's got running room. He's going to turn it to the 20. He could go all the way. 10, 5. Right down to the 3-yard line. What a big run for Rocco Marciarella. Broke a couple tackles. It's going to be first and goal from the 3. First and goal for Redding from their 4-yard line. Murphy under center. Kobe Goodchild, the lone setback. He's going to throw. He has an open man. It was Iapika, but throw was a little to the right, and 12 stepped in and almost intercepted it.
We were just saying off camera there that we should get to Iapika, Dave.
Yeah. He's got wheels.
Talking about some wheels he's
got. Yeah, he's got, I think, some of the best speed on the team. If they can get him in open field, he'll be gone. We have Ryan Strout left, split left. Puelli out right. Beckenhuis and Kobe Goodchild in the backfield. Murphy calling signals. He looks like he's changing the play at the line of scrimmage.
Looks like Tom Brady out there.
Very professional looking offensive set. He comes back to throw. Incomplete. It's going to be third down and goal from the 4 or 5 yard line there.
Oh.
Okay. Third and goal, I believe, from here. And it's a handoff to Ben Wright. He has a lane. Can he get in? Right on the goal line. It's going to be fourth and very short. Fourth and goal from the one. Pauly comes out. DiNapoli in. Iapica goes in. Strout comes out. And Rocco Masciarelli. They have their short yardage running backs in here. Our two power runners, Masciarelli and Beckenhuis. Those guys can move the pile. And we got some good blockers up front. It's a handoff up the middle to Beckenhuis. And he's right in there. Touchdown for Reading. It's going to be 30-7. Nice drive for Reading. Reading going for two. Certainly want to work on their 2-point extra points here. They might need them in later in the season.
Iapica's legs come in handy here as well.
It's up. Is it good? Just short. Didn't look like anybody tipped it. Not sure, but he did have pressure on him on
that
one. It's
a pretty looking kick.
So with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, we have Reading 30 and Burlington 7. Oh. Iapica for kickoff. Kind of an onside kick, and I might recover it. We did. Kobe Goodchild on the onside kick recovery.
Looks like they're practicing special teams for the playoffs here. Which would come in handy.
First and 10 for Reading. We have Matt DeCourcy checking in at center. We have Sean Murphy at left guard. Ben Hennessy at right guard. Eamon Centrella, left tackle. And at quarterback, I think it's Rocco Masciarelli. It is. Rocco looks left. He's got Max Leone. Incomplete. Actually think Robichaud. Okay, let's go. Second. Down in 10 for Reading after that incomplete pass. Rocco Masciarelli in a shotgun. He's got Ben Wright to his right. He's looking. He has Andrew Tapia on the right side. He makes a move, breaks a tackle, and gets about three. We have Quinn Dolan checking in as a wide receiver. We also have Dylan Sweetser checking in on the offensive line. Max Leone as a running back. We have a timeout on the field. Jack Ramo checking in at tight end. Jason Anderson as a right tackle. Sean Murphy as a guard. Rocco Masciarelli in the center. Hands it up the middle to Ben Wright. No gain. It's going to be, is that a third down? Fourth down. Fourth down along for Reading. Reading not to looking to run up the score here, and they're going to go back and punt, even though they're in Burlington's territory.
A lot of great special teams today on this Reading side.
Yeah, and a lot of turnovers that have gone our way. A couple fumble recoveries.
A great punt here by Giacomo.
Okay, we have our long snapper in there is Joe Pueli. We got a timeout on the field. By the way, we're in the fourth quarter. I don't know if we mentioned that. The clock was a little bit wrong. The stadium clock was different than the official clock, and we just switched sides. We're in the fourth quarter. Now we're set for the punt. Nice snap by Pueli. And it's a good kick, but Kobe Goodchild gets down there quick and makes the tackle.
I think Kobe Goodchild could have caught that punt.
Almost did. Burlington will take over on their own 35-yard line. First and 10 for Burlington. It's got their reverse, and they're all over it.
Great tackle.
That was Pueli and Eamon Centrella teamed up on that tackle. Big hit by Pueli on that one.
Yeah,
he moved
just
it back.
Wrapped him up.
Yeah. Beckenhuis coming out of the game. We have Zach Galvin checking in at nose guard along with Ben Hennessy. We also have, who else is there? I think that's Max Rizzer as a defensive tackle. It is. Iapika is a linebacker. It's up the middle. Oh, they got some yards. Who's going to bring him down? That's Max Leone. Chases him down and makes a big tackle. Max Leone. What a great play by Max Leone. He didn't give up on that. Used his speed and toughness and made that play. To turn to the right. And they're going to get up about 6 yards on the play. It's going to be second down and about four. Ben Wright checking into the game. Second and three for Burlington. They're going in their hurry-up offense. Not much time left in this game. 7 minutes to go in the fourth period. It's a pitch to the right side. He turns it up to the middle. And bringing him down is Kobe Goodchild. First and 10 for Burlington. They're moving the ball quickly right now. It's a pitch to the left side. Handoff. He turns it up. Plenty of running room, almost a touchdown. It's going to be first and goal from the 2-yard line. First and goal for Burlington. Handoff up the middle. And I think they got enough. Touchdown, Burlington. So we have 30-13 with 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Burlington going for the extra point. They're going for one. It's a pitch to the right, turning it up the middle, and they got it. So it will be 30-14 with 5 minutes to go left in the game. What a beautiful day here today, Tom.
It's beautiful.
Perfect football day. It is. It's like 60 degrees and sunny.
Dave was asking me earlier on ways that we could use up the entire CF guard today. Talk about the construction on Main Street last week, Dave.
There's been a lot of construction in town. And here we go. We're getting set for a kickoff reception by Reading, and we're focusing in on the Reading C team cheerleaders. Tom, we just got the – oh, there they go.
Yeah.
It's a big squad, the Reading cheerleading team.
Going for the kickoff.
Okay, we have Colby Goodchild and looks like Ben Wright back to receive the kickoff. It's a deep squib kick. Ben Wright picks it up cleanly, turns it to the left side. He's got some running room, breaks a couple tackles, gets it to the 45-yard line. Nice run back by Ben. He'll take over first and 10 from the 45-yard line. First and 10 for Reading. We have Rocco Marciarelli to the left. Murphy in shotgun. I think that's Ben Wright. No, Aiden Beckenhuse. He's looking left. He has an open receiver. It's incomplete. That was to Andrew Tapia. Incomplete. Tom Dolan out right. That's Quinn Dolan to the right. Andrew Tapia split out left. Murphy in the shotgun. Marciarelli to his left. The lone setback. Murphy's looking left. He's got Quinn Dolan open. Incomplete. Fourth and 12 for Reading. They're going to go back and punt. We have Giacomo punting. And now James Murphy checks in. This is as a blocker. Must be on the punt team. Another good snap by Puelli. The kick is up. It's a deep punt. Wow. They're going to get about 30, 35 yards on this punt. Nice job by Giacomo. Burlington will take over. As Tom pans to the beautiful foliage, I can't see it because I'm colorblind, Tom, but maybe you could describe some of those colors that you see.
Reds, blues, yellows. Oh, blues. That's the sky.
Are we at peak foliage right now?
Yeah. I was asking Dave earlier what that numbers were. That must have been from the band competition last night. But
yep.
Resembled his wife's telephone number, I told him.
Tom, you're a comedian, Tom.
I know.
First and goal for Burlington. Maybe about a four-yard pickup up the middle. Jordan Whitmer checks into the game as a nose tackle. Second and five for Burlington, with 2 minutes left to go in the game. It's a handoff to the right side. I think he ran into one of his own players and one of the Reading defensemen. We have Matt DeCourcy checking into the game. We also have Brady Swanson and also Rowan Manahan checking in on the defensive line. Michael Fabiano, one of our captains, checking off, aggressively came off the field. Was there a loose ball on the ground? I think Reading recovered it. Joe Puelli picks up a fumble recovery. He's pumped up. They're coming off the field. First down and 10. I wonder if Reading will just go right into their victory formation here, or maybe a handoff. And I don't think there's any necessary reason to run any deep plays here, maybe other than practice. It's a handoff up the middle. Maybe a minute left to go in the game. Second and 10. So what a great victory for Reading, Tom. This is a pretty dominant performance. There's a couple situations where they gave up some big plays, but other than that, they were dominant both ways.
I think it gets us into the playoffs officially today, too.
Oh, does it? Yeah.
Well,
I know it was very, very close. They have one more game next week. I think it's also a home game, but certainly in good position. I knew if we get a 6-2 record, we'd definitely make the playoffs, and this would make it 5-2. Ben Wright runs it for about 6 or 7 yards. Nice pickup. They're really gelling together both ways. Game, the stadium clock says 50 seconds left to go in the game. It's third down and 5. Murphy looks left. And illegal motion. They'll run that play again. Andrew Tapia split out left. Jason Anderson, right tackle. Zach Galvin, right guard. Mac DeCourcy is the center. Sean Murphy is the left guard. Alec Grande, the left tackle. Murphy under center. It's a handoff up the middle. Maybe a couple yards. That could be the last play of the ball game. No? Quinn Dolan checking in. Andrew Tapia, A-Top, his nickname.
A-Top.
A-Top checking out of the game.
That would be A-U-P.
And that was the last play of the game. Congratulations to the Reading Rockets. What a great win. The final score, 30-14. Taking care of the Burlington Patriots. And they're pretty pumped up. They're lining up to shake hands. We'll sign off now. We'll make room for the Reading B team to come in. And we'll get excited about our last regular season game of the season next week.
Fantastic. I'm going to run them through the line here, Dave.
All right. Good sportsmanship here. We got a little extra time on the chip.
I think the CF card ran out about an hour ago.
They gave us our own chip because we were running long in a lot of those games, Tom.
I know.
I think it was me talking more than you, but no. Still.
Man, a few words.
But they're always insightful. Those few words you have.
They are.
Certainly contribute quite a bit.
Kids looking excited today.
Great win for Reading.
We'll wrap it up. That's a wrap, Dave.